What's up, guys? Been a long time since I made a video. Just been really busy. Made a couple videos, just didn't like how they came out, so I never posted them, but figured I'd just do a little video here. Maybe it'll help some people, I don't know. It's not a hard job to do. But it's a cat sweeper, bu118. Replacing the brushes on it, so I'll just give a couple of little tips. I didn't want to make a video of doing the whole thing, but let me move this out of the way. So what you're gonna do to start, you want the sweeper sitting where the brushes are just hitting the ground. Then loosen these bolts up here. You gotta back off of this completely. You'll see when I go to install it, I'll show why. Not completely, you don't have to take it completely out, but it needs to be loose. This needs to be able to flip up, and it can't flip up if this back nut is tightened all the way up to this. So what this bolt does, you adjust your sweeper head from that bolt. So you start it out with this back nut here pushed out more when you have new brooms on it, and then as they wear down, you bring it in more and more and more and more. So this one, the rubber's in really rough shape. I just did another one last week. I'm doing these like every, so the asphalt companies I do work for, they use them all the time. The two asphalt companies I do work for. So this company has two of them. The other company I do work for, they have one. He seems to go through brushes a little bit more. Once every, I don't know, 5 months, 4 months. This one's probably once every 6 months between the two of them. So, you know, loosen up this bolt here. You got these four bolts. This is where your motor is. So you loosen up these four bolts. Then on this side, you can take off this plate. It will make it easier. I like having it on, because then you're not lining both of them up. There's a slot obviously in here for it to drop out. You loosen those four bolts off, 16 millimeter. Your guards here are 13 millimeter. This one's missing the front one. Then this plate here is on top, goes up there, and that's just two 13 millimeter bolts there. Then when you go to put the brushes on, so just a disclaimer here, I've never been taught how to do this stuff. Most of this stuff I'm self-taught on. So the way I do it, which I don't know if it's the right way or not, put one of these boxes upside down, because what I do is these here, I stagger these because there's three bars on there. So I put one on one bar, one on the other bar, one on the other bar. And your stainless steel ones, or I don't even know if they are stainless, the metal broom, this is the one I have upside down, which it doesn't matter, they're the same all the way around. But when you pick these up, don't pick it up from one end. Let's see if it'll do it. But if you pick it up from one end, no, it didn't do it. But if you have a full box, it's usually doing it the first couple ones. They get intertangled and you get a bitch to get apart. So I use two hands, one on each side, pick it up evenly. And then I stagger them on here. Your pins go around this. And you just stagger each one. Let me see if I can find a spot to put you guys here. You can hang out in the back of my truck while I do this. That should be good enough. And you're gonna have some of these extra. Now I gotta see where I left off at. So I'm on that floor. I mean, it's basically self-explanatory, but this is just the way I do it. I'll also set those. You're usually going to have some left over. We can't fit a full one on that. So we take one of these. And I'll show you. You probably not going to be able to see it from there. But if I put it where it was going to go, it's not going to have room. You can't get that plate on there now. It's too high. So, take another one. Where is my thing? So I need to be on this one. Oh, sorry. I still did it wrong. And you're just putting this last one. Almost every single one comes out like this. This last one is the same as this one here. You see how these ones have a gap in there? But this one, no gap. It follows the contour of the last one. So I'm gonna stick you guys back up here while I set this whole thing up. should be doing this with gloves. I don't have anywhere to stick you guys over here. This place is a fucking mess right now. Let's see how this works. So, try to get this. I should have already put this hose in there. The problem with the broom is when you push one side, it pulls on the other side. So it's a pain to line it up. But if you put these hoses in here, it helps a little bit with that. Line it up the best you can. It's like 28 degrees on, and I had this heat on in here. Now I'm dying. So by leaving that bearing on the side, it makes it a pain in the ass to line this up. If you have two people, it's much easier. But I guess we'll bring it down and realign it. Make sure that you have most of these in. This is going to hit, so it's probably going to get caught. Thank you. down. Oh, I got lucky it went in place, but I can't show it now. And at this point, I use the jack. Up the motor, use the lineup bar to line up these holes. This side's a little more tricky because you have a bearing on here. The other side, you got a motor. That side's got a motor, so it's something to jack onto. But on this side, if you take this bearing, you hit one side of it, and it's going to tilt the bearing back. That way you can easily get it. Now we're going to try. Usually I'm up too high, but this one, for whatever reason, usually this is all the way up here, and then I jack up the body to it. But this time, it's the opposite way. Kind of sucks. Then you can just rotate to it. These things just move a lot. Those brushes just push it wherever it wants to go. bolts for these skirts.
Just one.
Bolts always wear down to the skirt. Good, good, good. Good. This one. The head always gets worn down because of curves. Before we do that, I really wish I had time to edit these videos because all this other bullshit I can edit out, so my apologies. But it's gonna be a long video. Then we'll adjust this. My instant 3/8 wrench. I went in my toolbox and my truck was here. I wasn't. I was moving a machine. Guys I do work for, not the company I work for, but one of the my customers, they park here at this yard, and they came and borrowed some wrenches without me knowing. I don't have the wrench. mine is probably stuck.
No, I got that one.
Thankfully. No. Just barely. Another tip, make sure you get both of them started first. You screw yourself. Really take the time to edit these because nobody's probably even watching now, but as it wears down, you back off off of this one, tighten this one down. But these guys always run these things down to nothing. That's that. So, sorry for a long video, but I wanted to post something. I've been debating on doing it for a while. Because for somebody that just started out, you know, I started this channel last year, and I got a lot of support, like, pretty quick, as far as I'm concerned. First couple videos did very well. I was very happy with them. So thank you for the support. I'm going to try to post more videos. They might be shitty like this one, but thank you for watching.